if Trump wasn't the president and someone went to court in the Southern District of New York, sponsored information that they directed a crime, what would happen to that person?
Well, that person would be in serious jeopardy of being charged because the government wouldn't make that sponsoring allegation if they weren't seriously contemplating going forward with criminal charges. Now, where it stands here, I can't say.
Well, there's the former FBI director, James Comey, saying Justice Department policy is that a sitting president cannot be indicted. Not everyone thinks that Trump could be off the hook. Judge Andrew Napolitano, Fox News senior judicial analyst, a lot of views on this. How you doing, sir? Good morning,
Good
to
Bill.
You. You
Good
had
morning.
Plenty to read over the weekend. What's your position on what we think we know right now as of late Friday?
That the most dangerous to the president filing last week was the filing by federal prosecutors here in New York, professional prosecutors, not Bob Mueller's team, saying that the president paid Michael Cohen to commit a crime. Now, under the law, that would make the president as criminally liable as Michael Cohen. So if you pay me to shoot somebody and I shoot them, you're as liable as if you had pulled the trigger. That's the basic principle of law. This is the Southern District of New York. This is the oldest and most prestigious federal prosecutor's office in the country. They would not make an allegation like that if they did not have corroborated evidence to support it. And they cannot make an allegation like that unless they're going to do something with it. Now, Director Comey is right. The Justice Department has all kinds of rules and regulations. They have three legal opinions on whether a sitting president can be indicted. Two say no and one says yes. But all three agree that if the statute of limitations is about to expire, then the government needs to do something to stop the running of the statute of limitations, which would mean a secret indictment about which the public doesn't know. Statute of limitations, is here it's 5 years, and the Cohen crimes to which he pleaded guilty were committed in 2013, 15, and 16, so you can do the math.
Okay. Rudy Giuliani on Sunday, I don't know if you saw this or not, but
there's
his message after he saw everything. No collusion, he writes, no obstruction, now campaign finance. But payments to settle lawsuits are not clearly a proper campaign contribution or expenditure. No responsible lawyer would charge a debatable campaign finance violation as a crime. Well, maybe those suffering from TDD. That was not defined. I assume that means Trump derangement disorder.
It's very strange to hear Rudy criticizing his former office. I mean, this office has had storied leadership, including Tom Dewey, Jim Comey, and Rudy himself. They persuaded a federal judge and the lawyers for Michael Cohen that the hundreds of thousands of dollars that were paid to silence the women who say they had relations with the president, which the president has denied, was either a campaign contribution or an expenditure by the campaign, both of which are crimes. And I think Rudy should understand that. I believe that the president and Rudy mock the government at their peril. That's how serious these allegations
are.
What
he's saying about the payments, though, no responsible lawyer would charge a debatable campaign finance violation as a crime.
It's not debatable, and the responsible lawyers who he's saying wouldn't do this are the professional people, not the political appointee who recused himself, Jeff Berman, but the professional people who run the Southern District of New York.
What is your view on indicting a sitting president? Is it allowed or not?
My view is that he can be indicted but cannot be prosecuted until after leaving office, because the disruption to the government would be far more than the Constitution of the prosecution than the Constitution tolerates.
I think Giuliani has said before they'll fight it up to the U.S. Supreme Court. Was that fighting the indictment or if there were a subpoena?
I think they'll fight both all the way to the Supreme Court. They'll lose on the subpoena because the Supreme Court has already ruled on that. I don't know where they'll go on the indictment. Okay. If an indictment comes. Look, Rudy's goal is not to dissuade prosecutors from indicting the president. Rudy's goal, and it's an admirable one, is to create an atmosphere of public opinion so that if the president is indicted or is charged with an impeachable offense by a Democratic House, the public wouldn't tolerate it. That's what Rudy's trying to do.
Andrew McCarthy works with us, filed a piece over the weekend at FoxNews.com. Said prosecutors would not have done this if the president was not on their radar screen. Indeed, if the president was not implicated, I suspect that they would not have prosecuted Cohen for campaign finance violations at all. If he is on their radar screen, he is on their screen for what?
Fully agreed with what Andy McCarthy said. He is on their radar screen for paying someone to commit a crime. which in itself is three crimes.
So it's, you had, go ahead.
It's the crime, it's conspiracy to commit the crime, and it's procuring someone to commit a crime. So he's actually, if all this is correct, and if they have the evidence for it, exposed to more criminal activity than Michael Cohen.
Okay, so to many of those who say this is a charge that's settled by a penalty, based on a dollar amount. John Edwards was tried on this.
Yes, and Michael Cohen
got off on it. John Edwards, I believe, used money from his own campaign.
Yes.
And if all this is true that you're explaining us today, this did not come from campaign money, correct?
Well, if it didn't,
it would have come from President Trump's own personal account.
Then it was a gift to the campaign, which the campaign can't accept.
So that in itself is still illegal.
That's the crime for which Michael Cohen pleaded guilty and for which the Southern District of New York says the president bears culpability.
Last point here. As you go through all this over the weekend, what is the course it's likely to take? What would be your expectation, Judge?
That something will happen, not by Bob Mueller's team, but by the federal prosecutors here in New York with respect to the president. I'm fully in accord with Andy McCarthy. They cannot make an allegation of this gravity without following through on it. And that will probably provoke the Democrats in the House to have a field day with it. Listen, what the Democrats in the House do is a political question. I can't predict which way that's going to go. They'll do what they think will help them politically.
Nadler seemed to ride the fence in his comment over the weekend.
Congressman Nadler, and I respect his views on civil liberties, we're in accord on this. But the politicians will make a decision on what's best for them politically. Remember when the Republicans impeached Bill Clinton? Clinton kept smiling, and his approval ratings went up, and theirs went down. The same thing could happen here.
Clinton gained House seats in 1998.
Yes, he did.
Thank you.
As a consequence of that ill-advised impeachment.
See you soon.
Okay.
Thank you.